specifically designed to withstand the conditions there. The Dyson has reported some technical issues, but they should still be in transporter range. It will be standing by to assist you when you've completed your mission.
Is Dr. Eric Cooper, the Federation Science Council's expert on Dyson technology.
Yes. Hello, I'm Dr. Cooper.
so we may determine the best plan of action. Main power is offline. I am not sure what caused this disruption, but the event was fortunate. The darkness is a distinct tactical advantage. There are manual overrides in each room. I have temporarily disabled the one between us and the Voth. The Dyson's captain has moved ahead to determine what is beyond the next door. There are two generator rooms that control much of the station's operations. The generator room to the south controls the power. The control room to the west, where the Voth are, maintains the station's jump capabilities. It is imperative we reach the west control room and disable it before the Voth jump this sphere back to their space. The release of the Omega particles needed for this reaction would be catastrophic. More than the three of us can safely engage. Defeat would be certain. However, if we restore main power, we can use the station's automated defenses to even the odds, if we can avoid being targeted by them ourselves. I understand you have extensive combat experience. Do you have any suggestions? I have attempted to hail them, but received no response. The ship's shields and hull plating are designed to withstand the extreme amounts of heat, pressure, and radiation generated by this sphere's star. However, it is a prototype vessel on its first voyage. There were several unexpected system failures. The ship has retreated to a safe location to make repairs. Until they are able to complete them, they will not be able to assist us.
We're moving away from the Voth, right?
Defenses in here can be quite lethal.
It was awful. The sounds, the blood. Ugh.
The other two. If we don't, the system will defend itself. Also,
Activating the wrong consoles will trigger the system's defenses. Be careful. That looks right. That looks right. That did it. The final console is unlocked.
Stranded ship. choose to do so, I will support you. I can alter the programming of the security swarmers that normally patrol this area. They will attack the Voth, but they also will attack us if there are no other targets. The swarmers will provide a distraction for us, but they could also be a liability. I can activate beams of energy that will shoot down in set periods of time. I do not have any further control than that. But you could lure some of the Voth into the beams. The beams are quite deadly, so I would advise keeping your distance. This would be our easiest option against the Voth, but if we are not careful, we could be caught in the beams. Would you prefer I activate the beams? here, all that is between us and our goal is the vacuum of space. My modification successfully locked the Voth out of this area. However, there was an armed Voth battlesuit in the corridor. The station's automated swarmers attacked, and this is the result. No response. According to my readings, there is no method of direct access. Unless your ship is within range, we are stranded.
I'm here! Wait!
Doctor, we require a way to access the other areas of the station. Your thoughts?
I have an idea, but you may not like it. Those EV suits over there, they have maneuvering jets that we could use on the outside of the station. I've looked them over, and they should be able to withstand the heat of the sun.
Should?
Well, nothing will withstand that much heat and radiation for long. The suits appear to be designed for use in the shadow of the station, but technically they can keep us safe for a little while.
They will have to suffice. We have no other logical option.
Doctor, are you going to prepare your suit?
Me? Of course not! It's far too risky for me to go out there!
We will need to convince Cooper to overcome his fear and help us complete our mission.
Do you really need me out there? Internal comms are still active. I could just tell you what you have to do. I really can't stand any more stress. I have no idea why Admiral Tuvok chose me for this project. I know, but flying over a star? It's crazy! I don't even like using the holodeck! Well, I've seen the stories about you. You've been through a lot for one captain. If you can do this, maybe I can too. I'll get my EV suit. Let's go.
Thank you.
suggest flying a safe distance before activating the charges.
Are fried. I doubt they'll be much use anymore.
Thank you.
our mission. The honor of deactivating the station is yours.
Program is moving nicely.
Doctor, I'm detecting something curious. Energy levels in the gateway in front of us are rising at an exponential rate. It appears to be activating.
What? Let me check. Oh, this is not good. The gateway is designed to be an escape hatch in the event this station goes offline. We cannot deactivate the jump protocols without activating the gateway as well.
Is there any way to override the protocols?
None that I can see. If we want to stop the jump, we have to activate that gate.
It seems we have little choice. Your thoughts?
As Tuvok said, we have no choice. If we want to stop this sphere from moving, we need to activate the gateway. Our time here is limited. The Voth will return in force. We have to do this now. There is no other option.
Thank you.
navigational readings indicate we are in the Delta Quadrant. However, we are inside a Dyson sphere, and there are no known structures of this type in this region. I'm detecting the presence of a Starfleet vessel, the USS Gold. That ship disappeared on a survey of the Janolan Dyson sphere at the precise instant the Iconian Gateway network was reset to save New Romulus. This sphere was discovered by the crew of the USS Janolan in 2294. The USS Enterprise D rescued Montgomery Scott, a survivor of the Janolan 75 years later. However, it now appears that the Janolan sphere had the same jump capabilities as the Solanae and moved to this location with the gold inside. I am detecting disabled systems on the gold, but there is no weapons damage. Also, sensors indicate that the Voth dreadnought has its weapons armed, but has not fired. What do you suggest?
Activated. The energy readings were off the scale, then a flash, and my nav computer claims we're in the Delta Quadrant. If that's right, this entire Dyson sphere somehow moved itself more than 50,000 light years from its previous position. Since then, we've been stuck. I would have taken Voyager's path back home if we could get out of the sphere. The doors were locked tight, and the gateway powered down as soon as we arrived. Glad to have the help. Supplies are running low. But what was that ship that just passed us? Shares some signs of Voth tech, but our databanks don't have anything like that. Another Dyson sphere? It's taken us 40 years to study this one, and we're not even close to understanding it. And if that ship was Voth, it would explain why they ignored our hails. They came in with their weapons armed and then simply stopped. Didn't see us as a threat. The ship set course for the sealed door and is just sitting there. They're ignoring us. I promised my crew we'd get home. If you could send over a team with some spare components, I can get this ship ready to travel.
I have extensive experience with the Voth. While they are arrogant, it is not like them to completely ignore a potential threat. It may be that they sense a greater danger. I suggest we approach and attempt to hail them. Doctor, shields are down.
You're not.
You're not Cooper.
The weak shall perish.
Captain, the Undine outside of the sphere are powering weapons. The mammalian ship is still disabled.
Arm all weapons. We will destroy the creatures and then return for the mammals.
I am unharmed, but we are in danger. We are deep within the Delta Quadrant, right where Cooper wanted us. We do not know how long this infiltrator has impersonated Cooper, or the extent of what he has done. However, I am quite familiar with the tactics of Species 8472. We will repel the Undine and survive to warn the Alpha Quadrant of the renewed threat.
Finally, a worthy adversary for my new ship.
Thank you. real butt kicking!
Thank you.
have arrived sooner, but there was a Voth fleet in the way. Congratulations on a successful mission. Now the Romulan Republic will take over. We'll set up a command center for further operations. I'm sure Command will contact you when your presence is needed.
No! This ends now! Our generosity to the Romulans can only extend so far! The Klingon Empire claims this Dyson Sphere as its own! Starfleet and the Republic would be wise to keep their distance. Oh? Are you prepared to back that statement with action? The Klingon Empire has restrained itself again and again in an attempt to maintain this...
Fighting over this sphere is not an option. It would divide our strength. Precisely what would benefit the Undine. The Voth chose to fight instead of cooperate. They were destroyed. We can choose not to be enemies. It is time we did so.
The Klingon Empire will not sit and wait while the Federation and Romulans continue to claim these powerful weapons for themselves. This conversation is not over.
The Romulan Republic will continue to take responsibility for areas within our jurisdiction, but I do not wish to cause a rift in what has been a successful joint action. However, I will not be put in a position where I must choose between the Federation and the Klingon Empire. We have agreements on both sides that must be honored. Subcommander Cole can handle the details. I am a ship captain, not an administrator.
Cooper's departure has lifted the miasma in my mind, an affliction that I did not even realize was there. He was influencing me. He used the psychic abilities of the Undine to influence my thoughts. And the results are an effect of my failure. I should have been able to detect his influence. We have fulfilled our mission to neutralize the jump capabilities of the Solanae sphere, only to...
The sphere is under Federation control!
This sphere is only accessible through an Alliance-controlled gateway.
Then perhaps it is time to end this alliance!
This is neither the time nor the place for this.
Commander Jarak is correct. The Undine are a threat to us all. Now they have direct access to our space. I propose a summit. We must decide together what we must do to protect the Alpha Quadrant. Our disputes may need to be put aside in the face of a greater enemy. I volunteer to mediate these talks. Dr. Cooper manipulated me to achieve his goals. It is only logical that I take responsibility for what has happened here.
Very well, Vulcan. We will finish this later.
Thank you. previously held this section of the sphere until the Undine arrived. They launched their planet killers to destroy the Voth dreadnought. What do you need?
We are fighting a war on multiple fronts. We have to consider the Borg, the Undine, and the Romulans, as well as the Klingons.
I see now my deception has been exposed.
Starfleet has lost too many ships, and too many good men and women, to a fight we now know was caused by Iconian and Undine influence.
Is that...
an Iconian gateway? Yes. I believe it is.
Into the gateway! Now!
Are all those markers Iconian gateways?
Sir, we've been scanning the gateway. The monitors on the bridge are all showing an Omega.
Welcome to the Delta Quadrant. We are within the Solon A Dyson Sphere, a spherical structure built around a star.
We now know why the sphere generates vast amounts of Omega particles. It is designed to use those particles as fuel to jump to any area of space.
It now appears that the Janolan sphere had the same jump capabilities as the Solanae and moved to this location.
You're not, Cooper.
We will repel the Undine and survive to warn the Alpha Quadrant of the renewed threat. The Undine are a threat to us all. I propose a summit. We must decide together what we must do to protect the Alpha Quadrant. Our disputes may need to be put aside in the face of a greater enemy.
And now, the continuation.
Welcome to the Delta Quadrant. I will admit that I did not expect to be here with Voyager again. It is agreeable. Thank you for agreeing to attend this conference and supporting my position on the Undine. However, reaching a consensus today will be difficult. Many different agendas will be represented here today. I will speak to you in person shortly. Tuvok out.
Welcome to the Janolan Dyson Sphere. Please beam down to these coordinates.
Good to see you. I'd say you're right on time, but it looks like everyone else wants to be fashionably late. We're still finishing preparations for the conference. Admiral Tuvok is already there. The Klingon and Romulan delegates will arrive soon, so we should head inside as soon as you're ready.
Thank you for joining us here. We need assistance with preparations for the conference.
This Cardassian thug is trying to push Bajor out of this conference. We have as much of a right to be represented here as any other world, more than the Cardassians.
I simply pointed out that as a Federation member world, Bajor has no need to send an independent diplomat to this conference. After all, Bajor has no separate planetary interests that would require their attendance here. The Federation speaks for them. I wouldn't exactly say that the state of Bajor inspires much confidence. After all, it is a Cardassian space station that the Federation uses to police the wormhole. Even so, the state of security at the wormhole is far from ideal.
The Federation has never made a policy of preventing member worlds from overseeing their own interests in conjunction with Federation efforts. Or is Bajor going to be treated differently than other member worlds?
Well, since you put it that way, I suppose I'll just take my seat.
Where do you want me posted, sir?
Where do you want me posted, sir?
Where do you want me posted, sir?
Again.
Thank you for your assistance. Please.
Thank you for the invitation. Starfleet certainly knows how to organize their meetings on a grand scale. I trust that the Republic will be able to take a leadership role in studying this sphere. The extensive knowledge we've gained from the Solanae sphere should give us an advantage here. And, after all, the gateway that leads to both of these spheres is in Republic space. Yes, the Undine. Very interesting. My security advisors have been looking over the data, and we are all very curious to hear what you and Admiral Tuvok have to say on the matter.
Hope that the Federation is not wasting our time here. If your presentation is to explain the threat posed by the Undine, let me spare you the effort. The Klingon Empire has been aware of this threat for quite some time now.
The Zindi are here to support Admiral Tuvok's call for cooperation. We know what tragedies befall a people who are being manipulated by outsiders, as we were.
The Federation's position is quite clear. We believe the only way to safeguard the future of the Alpha and Beta Quadrants is for all of the galactic powers to behave as reasonable entities and work together to oppose those who would threaten our worlds. It doesn't matter if that threat comes from the Undine, the Borg, or the Iconians. The response is the same.
You've spoken with representatives of all of the delegations. You should return to Admiral Tuvok.
We are almost ready to begin. Will you complete the final preparations for the conference? What?
Suppose.
Yes, yes, I'm.
I was just going. Don't rush me.
You can start the presentation from the control console.
The Undine represent a clear and present danger to not only the Federation, but also the Klingon Empire and Romulan Republic. The damage done here by a mere handful of ships is clear evidence for the need for cooperation.
With respect, Admiral, the Romulan Republic is quite capable of leading exploration and security measures here, just as we have led efforts to secure the Solanae Sphere.
My militia.
I find it interesting that the Federation suddenly has concerns about the Undine now. Where was the Federation when the Empire discovered Undine infiltrators in the Alpha Quadrant? Or is the Federation only interested now the Undine threatens something you want?
Given the exceptionally complicated nature of such...
Ambassador, given what we now know, that was a mistake. The Empire recognized the Undine threat years ago. We didn't.
You admit you are wrong?
The evidence provided by Admiral Tuvok and his team is sound.
Thank you, Captain Sean. However, dwelling on past mistakes will not solve the problems of the present.
Our fleet stands ready to protect both spheres from the Undine.
The Undine can wait. We have more important business to discuss. Who owns this sphere? I represent a consortium of businessmen on Ferenginar. We are prepared to invest significant venture capital into transforming this sphere into a vacation destination to rival Risa. I have a proposal of $500,000 of... What's that?
Tuvok to Voyager. Report.
A massive fleet of Undine vessels just appeared from a rift. They're setting a course for the gateway.
The Undine? What do they want?
Unknown. Drop to Lisette. Track their course.
Enterprise to Captain Sean. We're receiving a distress signal from Earth's space dock.
Sean to Federation fleet. Red alert. Prepare for immediate departure.
The Federation is our enemy. But the Undine attack like assassins in the night.
We will crush the comic coup.
A significant Undine force is headed for the Sol system. We must stop the Undine from breaching Earth's defenses.
Several distress calls from across the system. Curious. Negative. The subspace relay booster network appears to be offline. I am reading Undine ships attacking Earth space dock, as well as attacks on the lunar colonies and the orbital habitat on the far side of Earth.
Agreed. Enterprise will clear the area around the lunar colonies.
Fine. Jarok and I will clear the far side of the planet.
Enterprise will set course.
Yeah.
severe structural damage.
Eliminate them. Any ships still in range? There are Undine hunting parties on Earth's space dock. We're fighting them, but comms are spotty. I was lucky to get an external signal work.
There are Undine ships attacking key sites across the quadrant. Our ships are responding to everything they can, but we're stretched thin. When the Undine arrived here, they damaged every ship in the system, hit the orbital platforms, and then most of them just left. Automated defense systems are offline. We're struggling just to keep control of the station.
The boarding parties on Earth's space dock should be our main concern. The Undine will be attempting to cripple Starfleet operations, gain valuable data, and capture ranking officers. We cannot afford to allow them to succeed.
Space dock has sustained severe damage from multiple Undine boarding parties. We must locate Admiral Quinn. The most expedient path to the Admiral's office is through those doors. Our mission objectives are clear. We must ascertain the whereabouts of Admiral Quinn and expel all Undine boarders. Teams from other ships, including some Klingon and Romulan vessels, have beamed to lower decks here on the station. While their willingness to assist us is unexpected, their desire to see this enemy stopped is gratifying.
working on the hull?
I don't know. After the Klingon Borg attacks during my cadet cruise, I thought working at Earth space dock would be less traumatic.
Indeed. I can initiate a mind meld. It will calm him, and I will be able to learn what he knows about the attack. My mind to your mind. My thoughts to your thoughts.
Feeling better now. Thank you.
There is more going on with these boarding parties than mere distance. Phaser fire. We need to manually activate the fire suppression systems.
I thought Earth space dock would be a quiet assignment.
Be cautious. There are more undead nearby.
Admiral Tuvok, I'm gonna help hold this position. I'm not much of a soldier, but I can make repairs and help keep this area clear of Undine. I hope Admiral Quinn is okay. He was on...
Be cautious. There are more Undine nearby.
I'll stay here. Good luck.
Admiral Quinn. shape-shifting nature of species 8472 makes them a dangerous foe. We will have to proceed with caution to avoid being caught unaware again. Clearly, Admiral Quinn is not here. He may be still alive elsewhere on the station. The logical, perhaps we can establish more reliable communications by directly linking to the Starbase's internal systems. The consoles here can be... I will cover you.
Who is this?
Communications are damaged.
One moment.
This is Admiral Quinn.
Admiral, what is your status?
I'm pinned down in my office with Egan. We've been trying to get internal comms and sensors working. What's your status?
The Undine boarding parties appear to have some goal in mind, but we are unsure as to what it might be. Admiral, I suggest you hold your position. We will make our way to you. Stay alert for more imposters. Still more Undine on this ambush.
Resistance Starfleet has offered is unexpected. That being said,
the weak will perish. And you are weak.
Ah!
is tapping the bioship's power matrix.
Into a trap. I couldn't stop him.
We have much to consider. There may be
was too weak. He spent too much time among humans. He served his purpose, and you will be far too late.
Too late for what?
Your quadrant will fall. The weak will perish. This dimension will be cleansed, purified of infestation. Your efforts are meaningless. I know your thoughts do not.
Indeed, Doctor. But I have taken advantage of this connection to look into your mind as well.
What?
I understand now what your plans are. You will not succeed.
You can't stop us!
May not have much time. The Federation and the Empire have been at war for far too long.
We have arrived in the Kronos system. At this time, the ruins of Praxis are concealing our arrival from the Undine. Klingon Homeworld Defense Fleet has engaged the bulk of the Undine forces, but they appear to be taking heavy casualties.
Just two Federation ships? Two? Where is the Enterprise? Where's the rest of your fleet? I knew better than to trust Starfleet. You run when you should fight.
The Romulans have promised additional aid, as has Starfleet Command. The Enterprise is contacting all available ships and...
Words are meaningless. Deeds show the true art of a warrior. Join me if you are not as cowardly as the rest of the Federation. Today is a good day.
Honor them.
The tide may turn against us.
We are
but
as
this
distinct.
This will be our day of glory. Think of it as an increase in your opportunities to die with honor.
Thank you. is that thing?
The Undine have brought a large craft through a quantum singularity.
They're powering up weapons!
Target that ship, and fire all weapons!
No effect! They're too strong!
Voyager has one nanite torpedo remaining from her time in the Delta Quadrant. Such devices proved effective against the Undine in the past. Tactical. Fire when ready.
They took some damage, but the Planet Killer can still fire. I can get the Aquarius into firing position above her and exploit the opening in her shields, but someone will need to keep the Undine distracted.
Have Sean's coordinates.
Getting locked now, sir.
He did it, sir. The Planet Killer has been destroyed.
Tuvok to Allied Fleet. Stand down. The Undine are retreating.
Captain Sean.
Transporter room. Did you get him?
We have...
Captain Sean to Admiral Tuvok. Permission to come aboard?
High Council wishes to discuss the most recent developments. We have been invited to transport directly to the High Council chambers.
There are many here who have seen the danger Species 8472 presents with their own eyes for the first time. Thank you for your assistance in protecting both Earth and Quonos from the Undine. However terrible, this battle did have one benefit. Today's fight opened the door to what may be a lasting peace between the Federation and the Empire. Now we must have the courage to compromise for the greater good. In its way, that can be more difficult than waging war. The formalities will begin soon. Until then, I must take the time to speak to others who were instrumental in the success of this mission.
That was a close one, but I'm fortunate Voyager transported me off the ship at the last second. It would have been a worthy sacrifice. Kronos is too important to lose.
Not be on the table yet, but I hope we can at least broker a lasting armistice. But first, we celebrate today. Earth and Kronos are safe.
You have shown your true nature today. Worf was correct. There is honor in the Federation. The conflict between us has gone on long enough. Now we should turn our blades toward the real enemy. I remember you from the Gateway activation. You fought well today. May our meetings on the battlefield always be as glorious.
I served in Starfleet, and now I serve the Empire. There are many on both sides of the current conflict for whom I have deep respect. I see this as an opportunity. We may find we have more in common than we realize.
Our people come from a culture of deception and division. We've rejected our past in favor of open alliances. Perhaps it's time for the Federation and the Empire to set aside their past as well. We would welcome a ceasefire between our allies.
My people have respected the Federation ever since our first encounter with your famed Captain Kirk. I have advised Chancellor Jimpok that the Gorn support the idea of a ceasefire. Perhaps this will lead to greater freedom for all of us.
Earth and Kronos are safe, and the Romulan Republic is pleased to assist its allies. I just wish my father could see all of us working together toward a common goal. This is the future he dreamed of.
The five races of the Zindi once tried to exterminate humanity. But through the efforts of a few people who were willing to change, we put aside our weapons and worked through our differences. Now, we are members of the Federation. Peace came with great difficulty, but that is the way of most things worth having. The Undine are here. And they're spreading lies and dividing us from within. Now, more than ever, we need to set aside our animosities and work together for the greater good.
I admit, I did not expect the Federation to act with such honor. I do not know what the final decision of the High Council will be, but rest assured that the Undine will pay. We will hunt down every last Kameku and destroy them for what they have done here today.
You fought well for someone from Starfleet. Many fine warriors have earned their places in Stovacor today. They died with honor, fighting one of our most formidable enemies. The Undine brought the battle to our very threshold. The fine warriors standing before me pushed them back. Let us honor our sacrifices and our accomplishments by ending...
Here to impress you, demon! We stand united, and there is no one who can... Ah!
We give you a single warning. Do not attract our attention again.
Together. It's time for our feud to end.
Agreed. From this day forward, all hostilities between the Empire and the Federation will cease.
The Iconians use servitor races and other species to do their fighting for them. Species 8472 has been an unknowing cat's paw of the Iconians for some time. This time, however, the Undine were defeated, and it was our combined strength that allowed us to prevail. Thousands of years ago, the Iconians were defeated by an alliance of races. I predict their ultimate aim has been to prevent such an alliance from happening again. There have been periods in our combined history when the Federation and the Empire have not been at war, but they have not been allies either. This may be the beginning of such a time. It will be up to us to determine what happens next. With time, we may even restore the alliance that came out of the Kittimer Accords. Voyager will return to the Delta Quadrant. There is much to do there, and the Janolan Spear will need to be protected from further Undine assaults. I am sure I will see you again. You have been a worthy ally, and your wisdom and courage will be called upon in the days ahead. Until then, live long and prosper.